Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Urdu Sat IAS Academy. So we are trying to cover current affairs in the form of MCQs for helping you in the upcoming exam of UPSC Prelims 2020. So today we will discuss the MCQs of 23rd April. But before that, you can download these PPTs from the link given in the description box below. Also, you can adjust the speed of the video where you feel comfortable. And do take a pause when you see question on the screen. Answer it first and then see the explanation part. And try to get at least 7 questions correct out of 10. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos. Do follow us on the Telegram channel as well. So let's begin our today's MCQ. Question number 1 is with reference to recent data presented by the Ministry of Agriculture. First, the cultivable or agricultural land in the country have increased during the last 2 decades. Second, horticulture sector has become a key driving element for economic development in many states. So statement first is incorrect and second is correct. Option will be D, that is second only. And the statement first is incorrect because cultivable or agricultural land has reduced by about 2.74 million hectares during the last 2 decades. However, during the same period, the gross cropped area has increased with the net area shown remained largely unchanged. And the target of food grains production for the financial year 2020 and 21 has been fixed at 298 million tons. And the important thing is that India is the second largest producer of vegetable, that is horticulture sector, after China. But do remember, it is second largest producer, not exporter or importer. So you have to check out which country is the largest exporter of vegetables. And if you know it, you can write down in the comment section. Now question number 2 is with reference to seismic noise. First, seismic noise is caused due to both natural and man-made causes. Second, high seismic noise aids the geoscientists in detection of small earthquakes and tremors. So statement first is correct. The second is incorrect. Option will be A, that is one only. So seismic noise is the unwanted recorded energy and an undesirable part of seismic data, and it refers to the relatively persistent vibration of the ground due to multitude of causes which include natural as well as man-made causes like human activities such as transport and manufacturing. So recently geoscientists have reported a change, which is reduction in the earth seismic noise and vibration amid the COVID-19 lockdown. And this reduction in noise will enable the scientists to study natural vibration even from the earth's surface reading and helpful in detection of small earthquake and tremor. So reduction in seismic noise is helpful in detection of small earthquake, whereas they could not be recorded due to high seismic noise, and that's why statement second was incorrect statement. Now question number 3 is with reference to hemophilia. First, hemophilia is a medical condition in which the ability of the body to clot blood is severely reduced. Second, the genetic condition is more prevalent in women as compared to men. So statement first is correct, but second is incorrect. Option will be again A, that is one only. So hemophilia is a condition which is typically caused by hereditary and lack of coagulation factor, that is blood clotting protein, and it is caused by a defect in the X chromosome. Since men have only one X chromosome, so men are more vulnerable to hemophilia than women. As you can see in the diagram, men having XY chromosome whereas female having XX chromosome. So men are more likely to have hemophilia condition than women. And the context is that Hemophilia Day is celebrated on April 17 every year, which aims to increase awareness about hemophilia. Now question number 4 is, the term anastomosis was in news recently. It refers to which of the following? So the correct one is, it refers to joining emulated organs. So option will be B. So it is a term in surgical sciences which refers to joining of emulated limbs or organs, and it is a surgical technique used to make a new connection between two body structures that carry fluids such as blood vessels or intestines, well, a successful surgery can result in the good return of motor function. Studies have shown that sensory recovery can often be poor. In the context of that, it is in use with reference to successful implantation of the chopped hand of a Punjab police officer, which was chopped by Nihang Sikh. And who are Nihang Sikh? This topic also has been covered in the recent video. You can check out it. Now, question number 5 is, Shangri-La dialogue, sometimes in news, is related to which of the following? So, it is related to Asia's premier defense summit. So, option will be B. So, Shangri-La dialogue has evolved into a key strategic gathering of the Asia-Pacific region, and it held annually by an independent think tank, which is the International Institute for Strategic Studies, and the ministers debate the region's most pressing security challenges, engage in important bilateral talks, and come up with fresh solutions together. And the agenda is wide-ranging, reflecting the many defense and security challenges faced by the diverse region. Now, question number 6 is, coronavirus seems to kill more men than women. So, what are the hypotheses given for this trend? So, we are talking about hypotheses, not the proven scientific theory. So, you have to consider the following statement in this regard. First, men are more likely to be smokers. Second, likelihood of women being more careful than men. Third, females tend to have a more robust immune response than men. Fourth, male smokers are likely to touch their mouth more often compared to female smokers. So, here the incorrect statement is 4. So, option will be C if we eliminate 4th one. And the 4th one is incorrect because it is in general true for all smokers that they are likely to touch their mouth more often and some could be sharing their cigarettes. And also, researchers do not yet know for sure, but several hypotheses have been articulated about this trend, as have been seen in the COVID-19 cases. And as the footprint of the disease, that is COVID-19, covers the entire planet, the same pattern was detected in almost all countries that released sex aggregated data, including Italy, Iran, South Korea, Germany, and France. Now, question number 7 is, RBI announced a 60% increase in the wage and means advance limit of state government. What could be the possible impact of the move? First, it enables state to undertake COVID-19 containment efforts. Second, states can better plan their market borrowing. Third, this move will help in providing permanent source of finance to states. As we have to find out incorrect one, so here the incorrect one statement is third, so option will be C. And the statement third is incorrect because wage and means advances are just to meet a temporary mismatch in cash flow, so they aren't a source of finance per se. Also, it is a facility for both center and state to borrow from RBI. So you have to remember this fact. And these relaxations have been made during the lockdown has resulted in revenues drying up, and it is the states that are actually feeling the heat. And with economic activity at a near standstill, there is hardly any money coming in from GST, petroleum product, liquor, etc. And at the same time, the states are also incurring the bulk of the on-the-ground expenditure for combating the novel coronavirus. So they need some kind of finance support, and that's why RBI has decided to increase the limit in wage and means advances, which is given at repo rate. And if overdraft is allowed, then the interest rate will increase. Now, question number 8 is, recently the term immunocompromised was in use. So consider the following statement. First, when a person's immune system is capable of working at full capacity, that is immunocompromised. Second, immunocompromised person usually stay sick for short periods. So these kind of questions are common sense based questions, as the term is immunocompromised compromised, so it cannot be a capacity of working at full capacity, and not possible that if a person is not capable of working, then he or she will stay sick for longer period of time, not shorter period of time. So answer would be D, that is none of the above. So as is the given in the explanation, you can see. So those who are taking treatment for cancer, smokers, those who have undergone bone marrow and organ transplantation, have immune deficiency, poorly controlled HIV or AIDS, may be immunocompromised. Also in the case of COVID-19 infection, these kind of people are more likely to be infected and would take time to recover from the infection. Now question number 9 is, in the context of Indian polity, who has the authority to fix the number of election commissioners? So as you know, originally only chief election commissioner was there, then the number of election commissioners was raised to 2. So currently, including chief election commissioner, there are 3 members in election commission. So who fixes this number? So the correct answer is D, president. So Article 324, Clause 2, empowers the president of India to fix from time to time the number of election commissioners other than the chief election commissioner. Here you might get confused with Parliament of India, so you have to remember president is empowered under this article. Also in the same article, president is empowered to appoint the chief election commissioner and election commissioner. Also chief election commissioner and 2 election commissioners draw salary and allowance at par with those of judge of the Supreme Court. Now question number 10 is, Lima was recently news, so where is it located? So the correct answer is, it is located in Peru, which is in South America. So here is the map is given. So Peru is a country in South America and its capital is Lima, and it lies on the country's arid Pacific coast. Also try to remember these kind of facts with the kind of trick. Like in this case, you can remember Lima and Peru in the way, as we all respect our mother, so a Hindi statement could be Lima per Peru. So Peru is capital. Sorry, Lima is capital of Peru. So that's all in our today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And now you can see the topics which we have covered today. One more question for you is that, who is empowered to appoint chief electoral officer in the state? Is it president, parliament, state legislature, election commission, or chief minister? So subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates of the videos. Please like, comment and share the video. And if you want to contact us, you can contact through the given details. We are always there to help you and solve your general queries. Also, you can get information regarding UPSC examination 2020 and its test series. So stay safe, stay healthy, have a nice day and thank you.